Hello, 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 hello. Hello, my God, just stunning and beautiful people. Happy New Week to us. This is your very own Jesse, all the way from Houston, Texas, shouting out to us. Happy New Week to every one of us. I brought us one tiny, tiny empowerment topic today. Very brief. It's going to be less than 10 minutes. I've not been able to show my beautiful face on Facebook for this week because I have so much going on with the group and my personal life. But I decided to stop by, you know, drop a word to wonderful people like you. As you listen to me right now, I want you to take something to run this new week. Your self-esteem. Whom you are. That is the news. What is my self-esteem, Jesse? My self-esteem is that I have confidence in me. I have value attached to me. I have self-worth because my Redeemer lived. It's about personal issues. Nobody can give you that self-worth. Nobody can boast your self-esteem except you. So I'm asking my fans globally, as you listen to me right now, have you identified your self-worth? Have you gotten to the point that you know who you are? Your confidence level, where is it? Is it in the hundreds or is it in the 10%? Where is your worth and your value in life? That is a question to ask yourself as you begin the new week. I have identified myself. I have come to the point that I can look at somebody and tell you, pure, no, I can't do this. I have identified my self-confidence, that I should be bold enough to express myself without being caged because of my circumstances. I have gotten to the point that being a single mother is not even moving me at all, because I know that does not define who I am. What matters and who I am is how I carry myself, my characters, my behaviors, the way I express myself in the public, and who I really feel that I am. My circumstances in life, my previous lifestyle, will not defend who I am for this new week. That is a valuable factor to carry along this week. What is your purpose in life? Where you are you comfortable in the place where you are right now? If you're not comfortable, tell yourself the truth. What else can I do to move myself from where I am to another level? Self-confidence. Have you decided to tell somebody that you have never told no, to make yourself happy instead of living a life of someone else pleasing every Dick and Harry around you? Have you decided to tell yourself the truth this week to say, you know what? I have been competing with Jesse so much. I have been trying to be like Michael. I have been trying to be like James. I've been trying so hard to be like this person. God, I need you to reveal me who I am really supposed to be. What is my purpose in life? So that I don't miss my own purpose. Have you learned how to be on your own lane, to maintain your lane and don't get deviated by the things around you? Self-worth. Are you original level or you a duplicate? Ask yourself that. You're looking at me. I am pure original. I do not shake myself to please people around because I cannot please everybody. Gone are those days I used to be in that bondage where I want to please all my friends, all my well-wishers, family members, every individual around me. I just want to answer a golden girl. Those days are gone. I refuse to answer a golden girl to please somebody else. Why inside of me I am dying in silence? That is part of discovering who I am. Today I can look at some people that I love so much, some friends and well-wishers, and I'm able to tell them, stop right there. I can't do this. And you know, it makes people very uncomfortable when you tell them the truth. Well. The truth is what you owe yourself. That is part of your self-confidence and self-worth for this new week. Don't come back at the end of Saturday and you're still the same person. The same list of people who are on your phone are still able to assess who you are and justify you for whom they want you to be. Whom they want you to be, not what you want to be. You need to start deleting some people on your contacts. That is a starting point. I always tell people, that is my part of counseling. You know, I always tell people, if some kind of friends are bringing you sadness, those are your priorities of delete list. Start deleting people who bring you down and not bring you up, because you are worth more than what you think you are. All you need to do is identify yourself. Every one of us is beautifully made and gorgeously created by our Savior Jesus. Don't let nobody put you down this new week. Go to the mirror, like I told my sisters during the workshop last week. Go and tell yourself the truth in the mirror. Look at yourself. That's what I do all the time, you know. Looking at myself right now, I feel that I'm so beautifully made because God created me in His likeness and image. It got nothing to do with my dressing, but who I am inside. I feel very fulfilled with God, what God is doing. I am not free of trials and tribulations. As a matter of fact, the more the Lord deposits in your hand, the higher the challenges of life. I'm a living testimony. Would that make me to break down? No, it's going to make me to know that my destiny is higher than I can even imagine. When you face challenges and tribulations in this life, you should know that the Lord is going through it with you. And at the end of the tunnel, there will be a light. And you ask yourself, what a marvelous God we serve. So as you go today, your self-esteem should not be very low. Your self-esteem should not be filtered. When we say filtrated self-esteem, we have three types of self-esteem. One is low self-esteem, high self-esteem, and filtrated self-esteem. On the low side, you don't know who you are. You're just belonging. They say turn right, you turn right. They say turn left, you turn left. You don't even appreciate your own self. That is a bad place to be. Wake up from the slumber sleep and tell yourself the truth. You are beautifully made. When you have a filtrated kind of self-esteem, you feel that you're better than everybody around you. You don't have humbleness in you. You feel proud all the time. And when you have pride in you, you are so destroyed already, because pride will come in and steal your joy. All you're looking at is somebody else. All you're looking at is other people. You're pointing hand. Oh, she thinks she is all that. He thinks he's all that. Oh, what does it? I will deal with him. Oh, I can do better than her. What does she think she's doing? What does he think he's doing? That is what filtrated self-esteem will do to you. Those kind of people are very dangerous. People that have filtrated self-esteem, they can poison others. They can kill others. They can sell you with money to make sure that you don't exist. You might not even have what they have, but they're bitter. They're jealous. They are so crushing inside because of the joy of the Lord around you. Such people, they hate to see someone else smile. They hate to see you advance to another level. They hate to hear good news about you. It's all about them. If they don't get something, someone else is getting it. They're bitter. They're very aggressive. They're ready to fight. Bad self-esteem. But when you come to people that have high self-esteem, they are down to earth, more like people like me. You appreciate human beings. You lower yourself because the grace of God is what is taking you to where you are. You tell people how to come out of their low self-esteem. You help people who think they are in the filtrated self-esteem to know that it's not the right thing to do in life. It's not about me. It's all about Jesus among us. Your high self-esteem will make you to see the truth, and you tell somebody the truth and nothing but the truth. Have self-esteem will make you know that you have confidence within yourself. You are a valuable and worth individual. You know exactly what you want, and you don't want to climb the ladder of success without carrying people to succeed after you. That is where you want to be. You want your esteem to be high. I hope I have made sense today. Tell yourself the truth. Don't die in silence, because you can do better than you ever imagined. And do not allow nobody to validate your joy. When you start allowing people to judge you, everything you do, they are judging you, they are correcting you, they are molding you, they are directing you. When you were down, were they there to direct you? When you were looking for somebody to just give you a word of encouragement, were they there? But now that you're coming out a little bit, you see people, they become the directors of your life. They are, you're, They are becoming your mother, your father, your brothers and sisters, because the Lord has decided to show a little bit of understanding in your destiny. Stay put. Stay focused. Carry yourself the way you're supposed to carry yourself. Allow God to come in and rearrange you. Jesus. That was the prayer on Friday or Saturday morning this week. We said, Holy Ghost, come into my situation and begin to rearrange everything that concerns me. In my household, Lord, in my decisions in life, in my circle of friends, at my place of job, Father King of Glory, in my marriage, concerning my children, concerning my ministry. Father, come in and rearrange everything that was disarranged in my life. And that is what we want to do this week. Welcome the Holy Spirit that is being given to you free of charge. To rearrange every situation that has been misrearranged. And you will see the glory of God in your destiny, in the land of the living. We will fulfill the purpose why we were made in this life. God bless you all for listening to me. And don't just wait to share this video. Don't tell me now, oh, well, I forgot to share. You must share the video, because if you don't share, you're a suspect now. If I have killed somebody now, you will see me on news. God forbid, because it's not in my destiny. Everybody will share it and make it viral. You see what I'm talking about? But some people will see this video now that can boost their inner self, their self-esteem, that can encourage them to stand up this new week. They will look at it and say, what does she think she is? And do you really think I care? I do not give a shit. I'm sorry. Sometimes we need to be real. I do not give a damn. Whether you share, you don't share. Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well. At least I say something and I'm happy doing what I love doing. That is part of having self-esteem. So, but I believe that my friends, well-wishers, will benefit from what I just said. And you will have the mind to share it for someone else to hear it. It doesn't hurt you. Whether you share it, you don't share it, it really doesn't take a hair out of me. I'm still going to be a motivational speaker. I will still throw my words out there to be heard by one or two people. And if one person can listen to this, I am already making a change. That is what we're all about doing. That is what is called transforming lives in the land of the living. May the Lord help us as we enter the new week. May we learn how to identify our purpose, our self-esteem. May we learn how to get out of our comfort zone, to be uncomfortable, to achieve comfortability. What did I say? Get out of your comfort zone, to be uncomfortable, to achieve comfortability. Three things together. You are very uncomfortable. Get out of that uncomfortable seat. Try to be comfortable so that you can achieve comfortability. Complete package of peace in life. I love you all. My heart to yours. Please share, 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 share. Make it viral. Somebody needs to be encouraged today. Happy Sunday and happy new week to us from Jesse in Houston, Texas. I love you all, but guess what? How you feel about yourself is all that matters. Bye.